ញ Samantha Samantha sok បាទសូមទៅដៃអបអរសាទរ
A pay my respects to the past and present of custodians and ancestors of the land on which we meet today. Today we, the first generations of young born to parents of Khmer Krom descendants, join with our parents, monks, friends and colleagues all over the world to mark the 73rd anniversary of the loss of our rights on the ancestors' land of Kampuchea Krom in the Mekong Delta of South Vietnam. Imagine the suffering of our ancestors, their land, culture, religion, tradition, language and their identity was being seized. Today we stand together to remember the suffering of our ancestors, but also to condemn the Vietnamese authorities for continuing persecution of our Khmer Krom relatives in Vietnam. In 1949, 21 provinces of Khmer Krom land were annexed by the Vietnamese as the French, who were supposed to protect and act as the guardians of the Mekong Delta, signed our land to Vietnam on this day, 4th June 1949. The size of Kampuchea Krom consists of 67,700 square kilometers and is more than one-third of the current size of Cambodia right now. The loss of rights, culture and language to Vietnam marked a dark chapter in the history of our ancestors and we. Imagine the pain and suffering of our past ancestors who had to change their last surname, and some were given the surname by the Vietnamese authorities long before 1949. I am Khmer Krom youth participating in the 73rd anniversary of the annexation of Khmer Krom land by Vietnam. There are more than 8 million Khmer Krom people who have been suffering for the last 73 years until now. I would like to express the idea of that we are Khmer people who live around the world, share the same heritage and the same ancestors. Should we continue to let the Khmer Krom live in this kind of suffering any longer? We should unite together to stand up, to raise the issue to the world, to put pressure to the Vietnamese government to recognize the Khmer Krom as the indigenous people of Kampuchea Krom, not just an ethnic minorities. We should not allow the government of Vietnam to continue labeling us as whatever we want, as whatever they want. Today, I would like to call on Khmer Krom youth to stand up and contribute their time by joining our activity to reach the goal of self-determination. This forced assimilation policy by the Vietnamese authorities on Khmer Krom cannot be forgotten. Thank you for your attention.